Nestled between Sarnia, London, and Chatham, Kent, resides a small town called Oil Springs, Ontario. Cyndie has lived here her entire life. She has every street memorized despite her inability to see where she's going. Today, she's giving me a tour as we drive around her desolate hometown.
We'll drive past my elementary school.
Okay.
So you can see that too. There's a farm behind there. We got in trouble if we pet the animals. We actually had they have a few goats. We had a few lockdowns because the goats got into our yard.
And do you think you'll apply to university or college?
I already have, and I already got acceptances.
Where?
To Fanshawe and Lambton. But I want to go to Fanshawe. My brother lives 10 minutes away, so I'll be living with him.
So I bet you're excited to get into the big city, bigger city.
I know I'll miss the quietness of this town.
How many schools are here?
There's no schools. There's a car shop, a TV store, and then a trailer park. The insurance, and then the library. That used to be a grocery store, but not anymore. That used to be a cafe, but not anymore.
There's no clothes and everything down?
Everything is just closing here.
Once a month, Cyndie can be found at White Oaks Public School practicing with the London Goalball Club. Goalball is a sport marketed towards legally blind and low-vision individuals, but can be played by all. Cyndie and her twin sister Cassie both have a unique visual impairment.
My vision is aniridia, so I don't have the irises in my eye, so I have just completely pupils, and I also have nystagmus, which means my eyes shake back and forth constantly. And then I also have cataracts. It's like a cloud over the lens of your eyes, so it makes your vision blurry.
I have the exact same impairment as Cyndie, but I have less vision than she does.
Playing sport gets even harder because my vision's kind of blurry too, so it's really hard to see the ball coming, and I've been hit in the face so many times by it, or get hit and get hurt.
The biggest obstacle for being vision impaired is people judge you, and they think you need help when you don't actually need help.
But here at Goalball, the twins aren't judged for being different. They are just athletes, and everyone wears blindfolds to ensure an equal playing field. The game begins as string is taped to the floor to ensure athletes can feel the court boundaries. There are three players on each team. The ball, which is like a basketball but filled with bells, is bowled across the court at the other team. When the opposing team hears the ball coming, they hurl their bodies on the floor, attempting to block the nets. Cheering is only permitted when the goal is scored.
I honestly was afraid at the start to get hit by the ball, but once you get used to it, you really get into the sport, and it's good. And it's a fair sport for everyone. Everyone's included, and it's great exercise.
Cyndie's boyfriend, Bryce Parker, is from Bowmanville, Ontario, but is in town visiting for March break. He is also visually impaired and plays on the Junior Ontario Goalball team in Brantford.
I met him 3 or 4 years ago at a rec tournament, and a year later he asked me out, and we've been dating for almost 2 years now, 2 years April.
I'm competitive with her because I want to help push her because I know she can do well at it, but at the same time I want to go easy so I don't push her back into the wall.
I don't think people who are visually impaired or blind are hesitant to join. They just need to understand the sport first, and then once they do and understand how fair it is, they love it.
For the afternoon drive, I'm Stephanie Kesler.